Siamo a 24 ore da un evento straordinario.
We're 24 hours away from an extraordinary event, the launch of Choppy Choppy, an 80-meter long pleasure boat built by Ancona's CRM Boatyard. It's 13.5 meters wide, has 100 kilometers of electric cables, 2,500 meters of floor space for guests and crew, and it even has the possibility for a helicopter to land on board. And this boat confirms the capabilities of the Italians as world leaders in an industry that has excelled in the last 10 years, the boating industry.
Probabilmente la settimana più intensa della mia vita professionale, perché un varo di questo tipo.
This has probably been the most intense week of my professional life, because we have chosen to open the launch up to the city. It's not just going to be a launch for the shareholders, but for everyone. Sailors, the Made in Italy crew, the city, the region.
Io scherzando dico che questa sarà una nave fortunata, perché una nave che in questi ultimi 4 anni ha
I jokingly say that this will be a lucky ship, because in the past few years it's gone through 3 different shareholders and 2 restructures. It is now definitely ready to sail around the world. It is an important moment that we're hoping will pass by quickly, because that will mean everything is fine and is going to stay like that for a long time.
Il cantiere CRN nasce 50 anni fa per la costruzione e la
CRN was founded 50 years ago with the aim of building and repairing ships. It evolved into building recreational boats, and since 1999 it has been part of the Ferretti Group. Lamberto Toccoli is the man who knew how to ramp up its status as a major player in the world of shipbuilding.
CRN è stato, diciamo, una buona palestra per tanti nomi che poi sono diventati.
You can say that CRN has been a good training ground for many names that have become big in the nautical world. Moving to the Ferretti Group in 1999 meant choosing to transfer an important part of the manufacturing composite to Ancona. At that time, I was in charge of Custom Line and had just created the company with Norberto, which was going incredibly well. But we needed different production areas. We are on the Adriatic side. Ancona has a lot to offer, and I remember the meeting very well because we had it right in this office, even though it looked very different at that time. Norberto told me, "Don't be daft. I can build steel ships." I looked at him and I said, "Really? And now look where we are." The strategy was to acquire CRN, change it over time so it could make steel, acquire Marini, and then merge Marini and CRN. Marini was a site that produced steel gas tankers, petrochemical and Atlantic fishing boats, so in effect, it was a shipyard. The merger has brought about the new CRN, where, in practice, we have begun to produce 30 to 45 meter long ships in composite and 40 to 80 meter ships that we can now say we produce in steel.
Quando io arrivai ad Ancona, cioè le lamiere delle navi si tagliavano in scala 1:1 e quindi si disegnavano per terra.
When I got to Ancona, the ship plates were being cut in a scale of 1:1, which were drawn out on the ground. I decided to put the engineering department here because I really have faith in the production house. But then I thought, where should the showroom be? And I decided to put it at the end of the technical department, which many questioned. So far away from the buyers. And I say, not really. I want the buyer to be steeped in the midst of all the people who are thinking about this boat and to see the time, expertise, and I hope good results that everyone is giving to this boat. There are 2 key factors for me in our work. It seems trivial to say, but they are the product and the customer. And you can't but get attached to these 2 things. Working in such a large workspace with such great elements, technology, craftsmanship, and in this great mix, external architects, interior architects, engineers. They remain those 2 key factors that make the product. We go out every day and see this quite majestic and imposing thing. with the person who commissioned it. I believe that if you can, and it needs to be spontaneous, not forced, you should create a strong rapport with the owner, who usually is a person who can give you so much, because these people are usually experienced and very knowledgeable in various specific fields, which can be a great added value for the ship. I say this to everyone who works with me. Apart from the respect and learning, which are part and parcel of the job, common sense tells me anyone, a good relationship with whom the person should really be thought of as your partner. Because in reality, we are partners in these 2 to 3 to 4 years of construction. That to me is very important. Building and designing these ships is part of a very complex procedure. It takes a great business sense to hold together all the different souls and passions that make up the product. Sometimes, it seems absurd to say it, but sometimes the great innovators are the shipyards, architects and clients. It's the construction sites that tend to remain conservative, because staying conservative means staying safe, less risk and keeping your costs down. Innovation is always opening that door that takes you somewhere you've never been before. In the end though, some owners are great and push you. Others just push you to make mistakes, so you need to be able to be firm.
La grande capacità è quella di saper dire no.
Which is great skill, the ability to say no, because if you always say yes, you are heading towards creating your own tragedy. So sometimes you have to have the determination and ability to say, I see what you're saying, and after checking that it's viable, to have the ability to say, sorry, it just can't be done.
Sembra assurdo, ma questi oggetti che sembrano...
It seems absurd, but these objects that sometimes seem enormous always carry imposing choices of compromise, and I always say that in a ship of this size, the engine room, housing requirements, the central stairs are constraints that you cannot escape. So how do you fit the innovation in then? Because it's important. Innovation means working openly and flexibly in a known world. Let me try to explain. If you look at the stern of this ship, we have tried to make it so it can open and close. So that big door there can take you through to the first part of the boat, which is a kind of terrace that overlooks the sea. Then you go through the boat. This is an innovation, but it's built on something that we know well and know works well. Too much innovation can mean big risks too. This yellow ladder is innovative, no? Well, yes, that's a banal innovation, very banal, in the sense that it is pretty basic. It performs 2 very basic requirements, or 3. Good visibility of the steps and security. Remember, we do things in an environment where we have to ensure our employees are safe, and so obviously, escape routes must be easily recognizable. And then there's a sense of cleanliness, a sense of keeping things in order. In my opinion, if something is yellow, it is maintained better. This ship is also Italian. The design is from Zucon International, and the interiors are by Laura Sessa.
Quali sono i grandi driver del Made in Italy?
What are the main drivers of Made in Italy, and how can you support creativity now in a depressed market?
La nautica è indubbiamente uno di questi cavalli di battaglia. Poi
the boating industry is undoubtedly a warhorse, but then sailing has always been a bit possessed. Something that's not talked about much is how it's always been thought of in terms of those who own the boats, not those who build them. But for me, when I say sailing, I'm talking about who designs the boats, plans them, builds them, and furnishes them.
Io credo che il Made in Italy continuerà. Perché noi...
I believe that Made in Italy will survive because, well, certainly for us, in this period of history, we are better at looking at what we are doing wrong, not doing well or not doing at all, and instead we aren't remembering what we do well and what we can do better.
Il varo può essere la cosa più intima, la barca, l'armatore, il cantiere. Quindi, come può essere in questo caso...
A launch can be a most intimate thing between the boat, the owner and the boatyard. So it's not an easy decision to open it up for everyone. Even in this same city of Ancona...
Non è un lavoro per tutti, saremmo banali nel dire che è un lavoro per tutti. Quindi la volontà di avere tutti gli amici.
We do a job that isn't well known of, and it isn't a job for everyone. It would be trivial to say that it is a job for everyone. So it's great to see all these friends here. I was very impressed with many of the people who have come from far and wide, even on a Saturday, to be one of the party, the big party. The brief that I gave, and you'll see, was something simple. There's no point doing anything exaggerated with a boat this big. It's too competitive. Something simple, with friends, loved ones, the people who built the boat, people who wanted this boat. I think it is with spirit that just once in a while we should celebrate with a launch. And this ship merits it because of its size, its history, and in fact, all the work that's gone into it. I was having a joke this morning saying it would be great if it was a Sunday already, because that would mean that everything was over and had gone pretty well. But instead, we're still waiting. It's really difficult to think that this is the day today. And this launch, they're similar to all the other launches that have gone before. Thank you so much. You think of so many years of work, the sacrifices, so much joy, so much enthusiasm, the difficulties, and then, just a few seconds, it all happens. So I think you have to step out of party mode for a minute and go watch this elephant float in the water and just hope that everything goes well. It's a time to take stock for a bit, look back at everything, from the day you saw the first sketch till now. Finally seeing it floating, that's what is intimate, a moment to share with just a few people. Even the emotion is strong. Strong emotion, yes. It's an important moment, regardless of the everyday things that we have to handle and battle against. We are human beings with so many feelings, without which I don't think we could do these things. With these battles, what remains of the pleasure of making these boats?
Beh, è tutto. È tutto. Non so se la nostra sia una malattia. Io domando a me stesso tante volte se quello che ho.
Well, everything. I don't know if it's an addiction. I ask myself a lot. What have I learned in these 23 years? And by chance or by choice, I am fortunate that I started making big boats in this industry. I started making a 21-meter boat in 1989-90, and the first boat finished was a 40-meter composite. The product is very difficult and complex. We call it the boating industry, but it is still a craft industry, a handmade product that is really still made by hand. It often starts with a blank page, from an architect's idea and the design of a shipowner. I've repeated this idea so many times that these are the castles of the Middle Ages that have moved into a modern era.
Oggi quando la barca, la nave, la differenziazione che noi vediamo su questi prodotti.
Today, the developments that we see in boats can be done on a few other things, and it's the passion that binds us. I don't think we could do anything else.
Perché io sono convinto che un prodotto così difficile e un cliente così difficile, perché indubbiamente parliamo con persone.
I'm convinced that such a difficult product is a difficult customer, and talking to other people should allow our experience to be shared across other sectors, across other business opportunities. However, I think it's like a type of drug. Shipbuilding, boat building, pleasure boat makers, they are all linked, and we're always looking for the next challenge.